so proud of you, so smart, and so sweet. I can't imagine they wouldn't want to snatch you up just as soon as they could.
I don't know about that. There are so many others, and they were so pretty, and the way they dressed.
But you're pretty too, Tabby.
Thanks, Mom. It's different. Their clothes, they looked so expensive, I wouldn't even know where to buy stuff like that.
Don't you worry about that. Real people don't care about those things. They care about what's inside of you. That's what really counts. And that's what makes you so special, Tabby. I know those girls may have their fancy clothes, but they could never be as sweet as my Tabby Cat.
You always know just what to say.
Well, you better get some sleep. You've had a rough day.
You're right. Mommy?
What is it, dear?
I wish it could always be like this.
What do you mean, Tabby?
Why can't it always be like this?
What do you mean, Tabby?
Why can't it, Abitha? Good morning. I turned in my application yesterday.
Good for you.
They said I could hear back as early as the beginning of next week, but it could take a little longer. There are a lot of applications to go through. I know a lot of people are going for this, but I feel like I've got a pretty good shot at it.
Oh, do you now?
There's no reason I don't have as good a chance as anyone else.
Why would you think you have a shot at this? You're kidding yourself. They don't pick people like you for places like that.
I've been working really hard on this. Mr. Sims has been helping me with the application, and he says my work is really good.
Oh, I can imagine what he thinks of you, all the special attention you've been getting.
Please don't say that about him. He's a good person. I'm a good person. I wouldn't do anything like that.
Good person? Oh, you're kidding me. Good people. You keep telling yourself that. It's a laugh. Don't start that garbage with me. If you're gonna pull that shit, then just take it right out of this room. In fact, Lyle's coming over soon, and I don't want to hear a fucking peep out of you. You got it? I don't need you dragging me down into whatever this shit is. Did you hear me? Did it get through in there? I said, get the fuck out of here.
Abitha, please, I don't want to talk right now.
I know what she says hurts you.
It was stupid of me. I shouldn't have said anything. It's always worse when he's coming over. Always.
Yes. It most certainly is. You know, you won't have to hear them for very much longer now. They'll be nodding off any minute.
Don't talk about that.
Just one little jab, and they feel so much better. For a while, at least.
There's nothing better about it. It's just gonna make her sick again. I hate it.
Of course you do, Tabitha. But haven't I shown you how much better it can be? How much better it can feel?
What you've shown me isn't real. No matter how good it feels, I'm not stupid like she says I am.
No, Tabitha. You're not stupid. Far from it. You just hurt. How could you not? She doesn't even see you. But somehow, she looks at you just long enough to find what hurts. Quite the unfortunate talent she has.
Maybe it'll get better. Maybe someday she'll choose to get better.
I can see you don't believe that. Not even a little bit. That hope hasn't paid you a visit in a very long time now. But there is a way. One way that can make her better. That can make you feel better. I've shown you what it can feel like to have her loved. You asked me before, why can't it always be like this? Well, it can. I can show you how it feels to have her love once, I can make it so you feel her love forever, Tabitha. You would never feel her hurting you again.
But it just feels like something that could never be real.
Never be real? You felt it. What could be more real than that rush of affection? The love that you hear in her voice. I saw how you smiled in those moments. The joy in your face was as real as anything else in your world. Why would you not want that to be forever?
And what if I do?
Well, then you simply have to do something very special for me. For us, Tabby Cat.
I've been right where I was supposed to be. She was late to the meetup. You think I should have just bailed and showed up without? Would that have been better?
What would have been better is if you were on time. Her new page is a goddamn phone, Lyle.
Hey, I have the stuff, all right? Isn't that what matters?
Oh, you want a gold star now for doing the bare fucking minimum? Give me a break. I can barely get you to do that one goddamn thing right half the time.
Well, now crawl up your
Don't
ass.
Talk to me like that.
Don't talk to you like that. Are you out of your fucking mind?
It's been hours already. You brought the stuff. Bust it out.
You're a real peach, aren't you? What the hell happened to make me so goddamn lucky?
That little bitch has been giving me fits again today.
Tabby?
Who the hell else do you think I've been talking about?
Jesus, Connie. She's just a kid. Why don't you cut her a little slack?
Just a kid? Just a headache for as long as I can remember. Traipsing around here like a little angel, trying to fool everyone into thinking she's so special. Well, I know different.
You don't know a goddamn thing. She's just a kid and a good one, too. Even I can see that.
See what I mean? Trying to fool everyone? And you fell for it. But then again, you're a pretty easy fucking mark, aren't you, Lyle? And you're gonna try to tell me about my own daughter now? What the hell do you know about it? You don't know a goddamn thing!
I know, I've had about enough of your mouth.
Wait, Lyle, okay? Just come back. I need it. All right, you know I don't like doing it myself.
I couldn't care less about what you do or don't like at this point.
Lyle, please, okay? Don't go. You know I get mouthy when I've gone too long. I just need to get right. I'll get right and then I'll make it up to you, I promise.
Get your hands off of me. You can't handle this anymore. I'm gone.
Then leave, you son of a bitch. I can't count on you for a goddamn thing anyway.
No, you're lying. You're crazy. That doesn't make any sense.
Tabitha, I told you, there is only one way to end this. This has her, and nothing will make it end. Nothing except...
Let me talk to her one more time. Just one more time. Mom? Mommy? I'm sorry about earlier. I forgot how much you hate when I do those things. I should have known you were busy. I think if I get into university, I'm not gonna go. I know you need a lot of help around here, and... Mom? Mommy? Oh my God, please wake up! Please, you have to wake up!
Tabitha?
Please help me get her up! Help!
That's the problem, Tabitha. Maybe we can get her up. Maybe we can bring her back. But it's only a matter of time until she is right back in the same place.
Don't say that. She's still breathing. We can still help her.
We can put a stop to that. We can put a stop to her pain. To your pain and having to see this over and over again. I told you, there is only one way to release her from this. You didn't believe me then, but now you see.
I can't do that. Please don't make me do that.
I told you. It had to be a special one. There is a cost to taking away such deep pain. Now you see just how dear it is. Release her from this, Tabitha, and you can finally have the love you deserve.
I don't know how I can.
Do it, Tabitha! Do it now!
give me a better chance to read the file I gave you?
Yes, Tabitha Landon, 18 years old.
Been with us about a year now. She's quite the special one. Might be familiar already. She's not exactly low profile.
Somewhat, yes. I didn't follow it that closely, but I do remember. It's a very sad story.
That's one way to put it.
There's not much to go on in the file, other than background information. She was raised by her mother, who had a history of substance abuse. There's no mention of her father.
What a surprise.
From what it says in her notes, there's been little, if any, progress over the course of her treatment. Her delusions about the events seem to have calcified, and her medication regimen has been ineffective.
That's why we're going to have you take a crack at it, Dr. Cross, to see if you can actually make any progress.
Of course. I do have to tell you, once the patient has sunk this deep into an alternate reality for this length of time, it's very unlikely that therapy will be successful.
I assume you'll be creative in your methods?
Sir, it isn't that simple, and I'm a bit confused as to why such special attention is being put into this...
You don't need to understand anything beyond the task that's been given. As far as I'm concerned, every goddamn rotted soul in this facility can be locked up and forgotten for all eternity, and that would suit me just fine. Unfortunately, there is someone who is still asking questions about this case. That is where you come in.
I'll do what I can, sir.
Good. Glad we understand each other.
Hello, Tabitha. My name is Jason Cross. I'm a doctor here. They tell me you go by Tabby. Is it all right if I call you that? Thank you, Tabby. How are you feeling today? I was hoping we could talk a little bit about your mother today. Would that be all right?
What is there to talk about? I just helped her. That's all I did. I don't know why they won't listen to me. I tried to tell them.
I think you may be misremembering what happened that night. I know it must be confusing, but it is very important that we focus on what is true. Do you remember when the police came? Do you remember where they found you, Danny? And do you remember what was in your hands? Try to think back to that moment when the police came in and you were covered.
She told me she needed my help, so I did. She said she needed to be helped, and I helped her. Mommy's all better now.
Tabby, in order to heal, we need to come to terms and accept the truth. I know it must be difficult to think of what you've done, but...
I know what I've done. It's all better now, just like she said. My mommy loves me more than she ever has before.
Tabitha, your mother is dead. You know this. You are the one who killed her.
I knew you wouldn't understand. Just like all the others, you have no idea. No idea at all.
We all want to see you get better, Tabby.
Don't you worry about that. You couldn't have done those things they're saying you did. You were only trying to help me. You saved me.
Now we can always be like this. I love you so much.